Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video guys, i-share ko sa inyo yung knowledge ko on how to open a savings account. So when we say savings account, we have a lot of types of savings account. We have passbook with ATM, ATM alone, and passbook alone, kabayan savings account, parehong savings account, and many more. A lot of the banks offer different kinds of savings account that fits your needs. So when we say savings account guys, ito yung mga account na pwede kang mag-deposit, mag-withdraw anytime you want. So, ayan, wala siya nare-require na days kung kailan mo siya pwedeng ma-withdraw, ganon. So, you are free to do whatever you want with the account. First mong gagawin guys is to go to the bank that you really wanted to open an account and ask for the requirements. Usually guys, same lang yung mga nire-require ng mga banks. So ayan, yung mga basic requirements na need ng mga bank for you to open an account is your valid IDs, original with photocopies, and 1x1 picture or 2x2. It depends na yan sa banko guys kung ano yung i-require nilang picture. So, for us, we require 1x1 picture and then along with your initial deposit. So, iba't-iba din yung mga range ng initial deposit, guys. For us, you're lucky that you're watching this kasi we offer 500 pesos initial deposit. Meron ka ng passbook niyan and you will get a savings account already. And yung initial deposit, guys, it means that is your first ever deposit to your account. That's why we called it initial deposit. Hindi yun bayad sa pag-open ng account. Walang bayad ang mag-open ng account. So, if you wanted to open an account, make sure na walang ganung klaseng, shall I say, kinokollect yung teller sa inyo guys ha. It is the initial deposit, hindi yan bayad. That 500 pesos will reflect to your account, to your passbook, if ever you will be having the passbook account. So, magre-reflect yan sa'yo. So, it is your money placed to your account. Ayan. So, yan yung initial deposit. So, sa mga valid IDs guys, we require government issued ID such as driver's license, Philippine National ID, voter's ID, SSS, PhilHealth, Pag-IBIG, ganon. So, barangay ID, and etc. So, if ever naman, yung ID mo ay hindi na naka-address sa present address mo, you have to have a barangay ID or barangay certification na nagpapatunay na dun ka na nakatira presently. So, yun yung tirahan mo as of the moment. Kasi, may mga letters kami i-email sa inyo and it has to be received by you. So, ayan. May mga thank you letter. So, ayan. So, for those who will be opening an account na meron ng job, so, we suggest na alamin niyo yung TIN number niyo at saka SSS number niyo kasi some banks will require you that specific requirements. So, TIN number, kahit na walang ID, TIN number, at saka yung SSS number, or yung UMID ID nyo. And then, for those students who want to open an account, we also require school certification, aside sa school ID, mag-need din kami ng school certification na you're currently enrolled for the semester or school year. And then, additional ID such as barangay. If ever hindi kayo i-issuehan ng barangay ID, you can just bring your original NSO birth certificate with photocopy kasi we need to keep a copy on it. So, ayan. Para naman sa mga initial deposit, yung sa amin guys, passbook with ATM, you will just prepare 600 pesos kasi yung 500, that would be the initial deposit to your account. And then, yung 100 pesos, yun yung bayad ng ATM card for us to request a card that will be named after you. So, ayan. I-request namin yan for the Mindanao area. Usually, guys, nasa 2 to 3 weeks yung card requisition before dumating yung ATM. But, for the Luzon or Visayas area, I don't know. May mga ibang bank siguro, guys, na madali lang maggawa ng ATM card kasi meron talaga silang machine for that. But for us here in the Mindanao, expect na 2 to 3 weeks talaga yung dating ng ATM cards. And also guys, we will be asking you a few questions for us to know kung ano yung source of income nyo, we have to know kung it is from abroad, kung remittance ba siya abroad, kasi we also have another kind of savings account na for kabayan or for remittance abroad. So that is called the kabayan account. So yung kabayan accounts, guys, mas lesser yung maintaining balance niya or even zero for other banks, and hindi ka magme-maintain ng money doon. So as long as meron siyang remittance yearly or even yearly, so pwede kang mag gawa ng savings account na without maintaining balance, as long as meron siyang remittance. And then for those parents who wanted to open an account for their children, pwedeng-pwede din 'yon, as long as able to read and write na yung bata. So pwede na siyang makasulat ng kanyang name at saka able siyang makapirma. So ayan. And mind you guys that I don't know if sa amin lang ba to, but hindi na kami nag-o-honor ng mga thumb marks as much as possible. Dapat signature talaga yung ilalagay doon sa signature card, kasi hindi na kami masyado nag-o-honor ng thumb mark. Case to case basis na lang talaga yun, and for approval pa. And ayun lang, just 3 requirements and you will be having a savings account that you can use for your personal savings, if ever may magpapadala sa inyo, for example mga bayad or something, you can easily use that specific account para hindi ka napupunta dun sa specific place para kunin yung bayad, ganun. Ang daming pwedeng gawin sa savings account, guys. And mas maganda talagang mag-open na kayo ng account for you to be able to save. Just pwede naman pa unti-unti, guys. Walang limit yung mag-deposit sa account mo, as long as pasok siya sa source of income na dineclare mo sa amin, ganun. So ayan. So sa mga nagtatanong, guys, meron kasing iba na curious kung ano daw yung pinakamababang pwedeng i-deposit sa kanilang account. Well, for us, as low as 1 peso, guys, pwede kang mag-deposit sa account mo ng 1 peso para hindi lang siya madormant, ganun. And wala ding limit sa ano. Pero pag if ever above 200 or 300,000 yung i-deposit mo sa account mo, we will be requiring you to give supporting documents na, for example, may mga clients kami na nakapagbenta sila ng lupa. So, we will be requiring them a photocopy of the deed of sale, ganon, yung mga acknowledgement receipt, just to support kung saan galing yung pera. Kasi easy, that's the way on how you can open an account to a bank. Just bring the requirements and go to the bank that you wanted to open an account and look for the new account teller. And if ever pasado kayo sa initial interview, ganun, may mga accounting interview kasi yan. So if ever ihahand in na sa iyo yung forms, that means you can open an account na. So ayun lang, guys, that's it for today's video. I hope you guys learned something from it, and don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and share this video to your friends para mag-knowledgeable din sila when it comes to opening an account. So if you have questions or inquiries or follow-ups or curious kayo on related to this topic, just don't hesitate to comment it down below in the comment section. And ayan, that's it for today's video, guys. See you on my next one. Bye!